Hey everybody, it's Dahlia Estrada with SEOmades.com, and today we're going to be talking about how to create headings in WordPress, and I'm going to show you how to do that, and I'm also going to tell you why you should be doing that. So it's going to be really quick and easy. This is for all my do-it-yourselfers. This is a common tip that I give people when I'm looking at their websites, when they want some feedback, and I say, hey, you're not using headings, and they say, well, why do I need to use headings, or how do I create them? So that's what this video is all about. It's going to be real quick and easy. So here we go. Let's get started. So what are headings? Headings are, the best way to think about it is like a newspaper article. A newspaper article, you're going to have your headline, right, that's going to talk about what the whole article is going to be about. It's going to tell you what the whole article is going to be about. And then you're going to have subheadings that are going to break up the content into more digestible formats. So here we have, if you see them, they look like they're just different size text. Headings are created through HTML tags. So here are your HTML tags. Luckily for you, if you have a WordPress site, you don't need to know any HTML. So, but I call them H1s and H2s and H3s. All the way down to H6. So here's your heading 6, and that's the smallest of the bunch. Why are they good for SEO? Google gives extra weight to any words that you have in a heading tag, and they go in order. So the most important text on your page, according to Google, is going to be what's in your H1. That's going to be what your page is all about, right? Just like your headline in your newspaper. And it's going to go down. So H1 is going to have more important text than H2, and H2 is going to be more important text than H3, and they're just going to go all the way down the line. So H1 is the most important one, and you want to have one of these on every single page on your website. Just one H1 is the rule of thumb, and you can have as many H2s or H3s or all the way down. You can have as many of the rest of the headings as you'd like, but only just one H1 per page. And there's also something called heading hierarchy, and what that means is that if you don't have an H2, you shouldn't be using an H3. You want to go in order. Not necessarily in order as in, like, okay, I have from top to bottom on my page, I have an H2, an H3, and H4. You don't need to put them in order on your page, but if you're going to be using an H4, you better make sure you have an H3, an H2, and an H1. And those are the rules of thumb. I'm going to do a blog post on this too to kind of clear it up a little bit, but that's the basic idea. So why do we want to use headings for user experience? Because it's not just for SEO, it's for user experience too. The internet has a short attention span. And so when I go to a web page and I see a big wall of text, that's not going to be very enticing for me to read. But if it's broken up and it looks interesting and digestible because it has topics and subtopics, then it's a little bit easier to digest, and it's going to be more likely that I'm going to read that. So it's good for SEO and it's good for your users. So we definitely want to be using headings in our web pages, on all of our web pages. Okay, so here we go. Here I am in the dashboard for my website. I'm in WordPress, and obviously it's a mess as always. So I'm going to come here to where it says add new post. And I'm just going to have a make-believe post that I'm going to create to show you how to use headings. Now, depending on your theme, your title, see where it says enter title here? Your page title might also be an H1. It might show up on your page as an H1 heading 1 tag. So if that's the case, then you already know whatever you type in here, this is your H1. And remember, we only want one per page. So I'm going to go ahead and type in here. I'm going to pretend for the day that I am a carpet cleaner in Dallas, and I'm going to say world-class carpet cleaning in Dallas, Texas. And then I'm going to say welcome to Carpet Pros. And that's my made-up name for my made-up carpet cleaning site. Okay, so it's going to look like, this is what I want my homepage to look like. I'm going to see how I use my keywords in that heading? I use carpet cleaning Dallas, Texas, and those are my keywords. So I'm going to put that in that heading, and Google's going to say, hey, you know what? this page must be relevant for carpet cleaning in Dallas, Texas, and so it needs to be ranking. So this is another signal I'm sending to Google that my page is relevant for those keywords, and so I need to be ranking, and that's what headings are all about. So I'm going to copy-paste. I'm going to paste in here a big wall of text that I stole from Wikipedia. Of course, I'm not going to publish it on my site because that would be duplicate content, and remember, we want only unique content. But I'm going to do it to show you how you can put headings throughout your content and make it easier to read and digest, okay? So let's pretend that this first paragraph here is my introductory paragraph where I'm just telling them who I am. And then, but I have more content down here, so I'm going to separate these two paragraphs with a H2, which is a heading 2. So I'm going to come in here and I'm going to say, why you should hire us. You notice I didn't use my keywords there because you don't want to overdo using your keywords and headings. I would use them in your H1 and that would probably be it. Unless you have a huge amount of content, then maybe you can get away with another header somewhere on your page using your keywords or a close variant of your keywords. But other than that, I would say just use them in your H1 and make the rest of your heading tags just about what the content is about, because you don't want to look spammy either. So here I went and so this is going to be my H2, and it says why you should hire us. And I'm sure you guys have better copywriting skills than I do about carpet cleaning, so this is an example. And I'm going to come up here. Here, let me zoom in for you guys. Okay, I'm going to come up here. You see I have my text selected, the text that I want to make into the header. I'm going to come up here to where it says paragraph and click there. And it's going to bring me a drop-down menu. So a little down arrow that takes me to this drop-down menu. And I'm going to come down here, and here are all my headings. Heading 1, Heading 2, all the way down to Heading 6. So I'm going to select Heading 2, right? Okay. And you can see that it kind of highlighted my text in the editor. And I know now that that's going to be an H2, a Heading 2. So let me turn off the zoom here. Okay. So, and now I can come down here and I can create, you know, maybe I want to create between these two paragraphs an H3. And I'm going to do it the exact same way. So I'm just going to make one more for you guys. Why we are the best. Again, I'm brilliant at copywriting today. Okay. So I'm going to copy, I'm going to highlight that text, and then I'm going to come up here to where it says paragraph again. Let me zoom. Okay. And I'm going to come out here, and I'm going to make this either an H2 or an H3, right? Okay, and then I did that. And so that's how you add headings. It's really, really easy. Let me turn off my zoom, and then I'm going to go here to where it says preview, just to be able to show you how that's going to look on the page. And it's loading, it's loading, it's coming, it's coming. Okay, great, and here is my page with my fancy headings. You can see up here where I have my fancy H1 with my keywords in it, and that's exactly what I want. And if I come down here, there's my H2 and my H3. And you can see that there's not a huge difference in the size of them on the page. And now, something that happens sometimes with depending on your theme in WordPress is that you'll put in an H1 or an H2 heading, and it'll be ridiculously, just obnoxiously large on the page. And you'll say, oh, this looks horrible. I don't want to use this heading. And sometimes that's a reason why people don't want to use headings, is because when they try to use them, they come out too large. But these are things that can be fixed through CSS on your theme. And I'm going to show you how to do that, too, in another tutorial. And it sounds kind of advanced, but it's really not. It's very simple to do. So don't be shy on headings just because of the size of them on the page. It's very easy to change it so that they'll be more aesthetically pleasing and they won't look too large on the page. So I hope that was helpful, and I hope you guys are all going to start using headings so that you can rank a little bit better for your keywords. And stay tuned for more tutorials from SEO Mates.